and incredibly charming. It's a real talent. She was magic. People wanted to be around her. Maripo is French. She was Madonna's stylist and friend. She's the one who sculpted her incredible styles. From the first time she met Madonna, she knew that she was looking at an exceptional woman. She had those big green eyes that looked at me through her batting eyelashes, and her big black eyebrows, almost touching like Frida Kahlo. She was so petite, so small. He only wanted to do one thing, hug her. And yet, from the very beginning, Madonna hit hard times. Even if she charmed everyone she met, she had soon been in New York for a year without much happening. She can barely feed herself. She worked odd jobs to get by as a waitress and housekeeper. No one took much note of her, but her round face, her brown mop, and her Italian boots shone out and fire. In order to earn money, she posed naked. Today, he still spent a fortune. Back then, Madonna earned $25 per photo shoot. Not much money, but it seems that she had no other choice. Was she really aware of what she was giving away? These sessions helped her learn to love her body, and perhaps, at that moment, to understand how useful it could be. At 19 years old, Madonna was already scandalous. She was willing to do anything to get noticed. She even took a role in a trashy film. The title? A Certain Sacrifice. Her character was subject to gang rape. This incredibly violent film was never released in cinemas. It was the start of a long series of flops at the movies. Manhattan, 8th Avenue. Madonna sometimes selected this brick building. This is where Camille Barbone had her office, as the head of a small record label. One day, the two women crossed paths in the elevator.
When I first met her, she was living illegally in one of the smaller studios in the same building that I had my recording studio. She didn't have any money for food or clothes or a place to live, and she basically would date a young man when she needed to take a shower or have a nice meal or something like that, but she was destitute. She started to clean some houses as the housekeeper for a short period of time, and then she cut herself one day, called me from the apartment, took her to the hospital. She had stitches. That was the last day she ever did.
Camille Barbone was hypnotized by Madonna. She became her first agent, and it was thanks to her that Madonna broke into the music world. Back then in New York, anything was possible. The nights were crazy, and Madonna was at every party. She's trying to become a dancer, training every night on the dance floor. She went out a lot. In fact, it's funny, you only meet people at night. I don't know if it's the same in Paris, but if you really want to be able, you aren't really going to during the day. You meet people at night. Like any girl hoping to be famous, she spent her days running to auditions. After a year of housework, Madonna, age 20, was finally spotted by a Frenchman. He was top of the charts worldwide with a single called Born to Be Alive.
Born to be alive.